Hi friends, now welcome to this edition of Final Countdown, where I am going to talk about the most important topics in radiology that you should not miss out in NEET. So let me begin by saying that radiology is a very important topic for NEET. Don't underestimate the importance of radiology, because you might have seen in the central exams like AIMS, sometimes they don't have too many questions on radiology, and AIMS is an exam which is more bent towards pre-paraclinicals. On the other hand, NEET is a very balanced exam where you will have good number of clinical visuals in the exam. Usually this is the style of paper. So I personally feel that radiology images should form an important part of your exam in the NEET. And primarily in radiology, what I feel is they will have more focus on images. Okay. So let's try to zero down on the style of images that I want you to look at. Okay. The first thing that I want you to look at is, which I'm sure you all are revising, but which is very, very important kind of question. Look at the questions that you will have in your exams, which will say, identify the structure, and which will have a image in the question. On the image, they will put an arrow on one of the structures. Okay. So this is one of the style of questions that I anticipate which will be should be there in this year's exam, because this was the style that was being used in the last year's exam as well. So now once you look at this, first thing I want you to know is brain, CT and MR is a very important point. Please revise from your class notes. I have gone on detail and I've discussed all the brain and structures in detail with you on CT and MR in my routine classes. Please revise that. Second thing that I want you to look at is chest CT, including the mediastinal structures like cardiac chambers, great vessels, pulmonary artery, this, and that is very, very important. Third is knee and shoulder MRI that I have shown you in your class. Please look back. You have taken snapshots in the classes, both in regular and TND. I have shown you how to look for ACL, PCL, medial meniscus, lateral meniscus. Very important questions for the future exams. Third is chest x-ray, knee x-ray, elbow, shoulder. Now if you look at your TND or class test that I have done, you will see there are questions in this pattern in the exam where we have marked a structure in the knee x-ray or the elbow x-ray or the shoulder x-ray, and you had to identify the structure. So I feel one of the style in the question will be identify the structure. Now the second style of question in the exam will be identify the disease. This will have common images like, now here I would like you to revise, if you are a regular course student, please revise your image book. Okay, so if you have seen all year along, I have taught you in image book, so you just need to flip through your image book, and if you are a test and discussion student or a regular student, you have to look at the class test that I have given to you along with the explanation sheet. Okay, so you will find, and plus you can actually add to it the DVT images. DVT images, I've tried to look at the image based questions. So diseases I've tried to cover in DVT as well as in your class, in the image book, look at them again. But do not forget there are some diseases which are hot favorite with the examiners. Now, like for example, you need to be thorough in brain hemorrhage, brain infarction. You can't miss them. And bone tumor is again a very hot question. Every year one or two questions are there. They might give you giant cell tumor, chondroblastoma. Like, it's one of the most important questions in your exams. And another is identify the investigation, where usually they will give you a barium image and ask you, is this a barium swallow, barium meal, barium enema? And like you, if you look back in your class notes, we have discussed this at length every year. So primarily there will be three kind of visuals in your radiology questions, which is identify the disease, identify the investigation, and identify this. In the disease also, remember to look for aortic dissection, pulmonary embolism, sarcoidosis, tuberculosis, cavitation, lung abscess, aspergilloma. And I'm sure if you look back in your class notes and the image book put together, you have everything with you. You have with you Monod sign, you have with you pneumothorax. Don't forget, these are all potential pictures for the exam. In addition to this, there will be some questions which will be factual, targeted from nuclear medicine. where I want you to revise for nuclear medicine and radiotherapy technical question. I want you to revise these sections from your class notes. Again, you know, you might think that I'm again and again saying, but there are some questions in your exams which will directly ask you the half-life of an isotope. And only the isotope, don't forget to revise the half-life of technetium-99m, cobalt-60, okay, iridium-192, don't forget iodine, okay. Even in this year exams like JIPMER, you have seen questions on radioactive iodine. Don't forget the isotopes that we use for bone tumors like phosphorus, strontium. Even in this PGI Chandigarh, they had a question on this. So these are, and you, if you look back at your class notes, you will find all this in place. So please look for common isotopes, their half-life, their uses, and what type of radiation is produced by what. And also look at what type of radiation is produced by LINAC. I have given the same question in your CBT exam as well. And common isotopes that we use in brachytherapy, radiotherapy, what is HDR brachytherapy, LDR brachytherapy, what is gamma knife, where do we use gamma knife, and so on and so forth. So it will take you 15 to 20, 30 minutes to revise these two sections from your class notes. And this is the total scenario that I feel will be there in radiology. What was, these were not, like if you notice in the last NEET, last 2-3 years of NEET exams, they have always focused more on questions like, more on visuals was the key theme. Clinical visuals, radiological anatomy visuals. Both these kind of visuals are the crux. So my suggestion here is, okay, revise your image book if you are a regular course student. Okay. Just flip through the images in your CRS. I have added a lot of images in the CRS. You might want to look at them. Okay. Images should be the main crux of things that you need to revise. Revise the half-lives and the radiotherapy and the nuclear medicine. I have actually, when we have talked about where to use technetium partechnate in the class, we talked about Meckel's diverticulum, GI bleeding, we have talked about bone scan. So look at them. Look at them. The questions in the NEET exams are usually more doable. So it is important to look through the notes. And I also want you to look at image source. The third image source is DVT. These are the only thing that you should look at. CRS, image book, DVT, plus look at the TND or class test paper. In them, I have actually added that shoulder x-ray, elbow x-ray, I've added everything. So please look at them. Now, again, if I summarize for you, the theme of the next 20 days should be revision. Radiology as a subject in revision should take you half day to one full day, okay, maximum half to one day. You should not spend more than that. That is the time frame I would want you to revise. And if you have less time, at least revise your class notes. This is the most important crux of the matter. At least revise your class notes and look at the radiological anatomy of the brain that we've discussed in the class, mediastinum, CT abdomen, look at the barium images, x-rays of the common part like elbow, shoulder, wrist, knee, very, very, very important things that they can be asked in the exam. And you have seen in ENT also, they might have talked about the Waters view, Cudwell's view, maxillary sinus, where is the maxillary sinus, where is the frontal sinus, just the basic radiological anatomy which we have tried to cover in your classes. Look at the class notes again, image book again, plus the common x-rays of, these are the kind of x-rays that I feel would be the crux of the exam. Other than that, there will be a few questions, technical here and there, which are there in your classes and notes. There is nothing else that needs to be done. I sincerely believe CRS images, CRS MCQs that we have done, class notes, they have everything inside. Plus the class tests that we have done, add to it DVT. I don't think anything is left after that. These are the crux that I want you to mainly focus on for radiology. And I also want to utilize this opportunity to tell you that now we have approximately 20 days to go for the exam. Next 20 days, your focus in any subject should be revision. You have to re-look at the things that you have done before. do not try to look at new sources. Some of the students are saying, sir, should I buy a test series? Should I buy this? This is not the time to buy things. It is time to consolidate material in your mind so that you reach to a level where you are able to answer the questions that you have studied correctly in the exam. So revision has to be the crux. In revision, I would always suggest to you, make a plan like this, that you spend some part of your day reading your class notes. By class notes, I mean things that you have written yourself by sitting in the class, by listening to the teacher. They are more easy to recall. And in addition, add to it any pending grand tests. Please finish your grand tests and class tests. Okay? So these are my priorities that should be looked at. Add to it DVT. And in the end, on the last day, look at any volatile topic for you. So if you were looking at the interviews that I keep doing with the rankers and the good people, good high achievers who have gotten good rank in these recent exams, most of them had kept a notebook for the last day where they had talked about volatile topics. If you look at the, you know, interview of rank 1 Archana, in the last few days, few weeks, she focused on grand test videos and she focused on forensic. For the last day, she read only the IPCs and everything. So this was her plan. You need to make your own plan. In the last day, look at your volatile topic. If you forget something, revise it. Notes should be done in the finished. Finish the pending GTs, pending class test and DVT. This is should be your priority for revision. That is what I feel. If in addition to this, you find yourself that, sir, I'm not doing so well. What should I do? If you want to still make a difference in the next 20 days, you want to utilize 20 days and get a PG seat, and you know that you're not doing well so far, I would suggest do this small exercise. It will change the game for you. Write in your notebook what are your strengths, what are your weakness. Okay? Note down the subjects that are weak for you. Okay? And on those weak subjects, finish CRS MCQs. And go to DAMS Cloud and listen to the videos of teachers who have discussed the CRS MCQs on those topics. You can do them in one day each and try to make, you know, maybe suppose you say my microbiology is weak or something is weak. You can add it here and try to make a circle. The idea is you have to look at next 20 days constructively, work on your weakness, work on your volatile subjects, revise your class notes and revise your DVT notes and see any pending class test and GT should be finished. That should be your top priority. I also want to add for you here. I also want to utilize this opportunity to add for you here a small thing that we are doing. Many of you have gotten good ranks in this AIIMS and PGI exam, but not as good as you might have desired. So some of you are, you know, you're writing to me, sending me inbox, sending me messages that, sir, I have a rank 1000 in AIIMS. What should I do? I want to target May AIIMS seriously. So now what we are doing in DAMS is we are starting at 25th of December. And on 8th of January, on both on satellite as well as face-to-face, we are starting a special TND focused on May AIIMS exam. So this is our planning, is that we want to help by creating a special course targeting the mid-year exam, which will start on 25th December and on 8th January also. So you can choose your batch and look at the option of going forward for the May exams as well. Anybody who is getting a top 1000 rank in the November exam should, or maybe 2000 rank, and if you believe that you could have done better, it is a good idea to target mid-year AIIMS exams as well. I also want to utilize this opportunity to talk one moment about the exit exam. Now, a lot of people must be telling you that today the cabinet in India has approved National Medical Commission, which will replace Medical Council of India in India. For future, and the exit exam is going to be an integral part of that. But the government says after passing of that bill, within 3 years the exit exam will begin. So it is not a concern for you right now. Okay, So let things formalize, let the rules come, we will come and discuss the, if any rule or any pattern will come, we'll talk about it. But for 2017-18, it is on at least in this session, exit exam is not a reality, it will come in future. So there's no point in, you know, debating about it right now. Cabinet has passed the bill and they will place it in front of the parliament. Once it is passed by the parliament, then they will, they say within 3 years of that, the India should have an exit exam for all doctors. That is the scenario today. So let's wait for things to happen. Now, I already, you can see on Facebook, so many of you are debating things. And I think people who have an exam in 20 days should not bother about all this and they should focus on studies. For everything else, you can trust me, I will take care, don't worry. I will take care, whatever the kind of papers and whatever, we have been in education for 20 years. We know our subjects in and out. We know our teachers know radiology, pathology, medicine. We know everything in and out. Don't worry, whatever may come, we are here to help you. Don't create panics right now. Focus on the task, focus on the task at hand. And the task at hand is R for revision. Next 20 days, you need to revise. You need to be thorough in your class notes, class tests, grand test. Let's finish them all. Let's look at DVT images again. Images would be the primary theme for radiology in NEET. NEET is more clinical visuals. That is the style of NEET. It is not about more factual. It's more about images. Images would also include radiological anatomy. Thank you very much. I wish you all the best.